Right. So, whenever the concentration of the protons are more in the lumen, then automatically they will move back to the stroma. So that is what we are discussing. As the thylakoid membrane is impermeable, the thylakoid membrane is impermeable to protons. They are impermeable, so it cannot, the membrane itself cannot able to pass the protons. So therefore, they will move through the coupling factor CF0. So therefore, the protons move through coupling factor, which is called CF, coupling factor CF. Okay, so two components, CF0 and CF1. So through that they pass, and then we see the synthesis. So this about CF you already know, we have discussed. So ATP synthase, we call coupling factor, or we also call it as or ATP synthase. Coupling factor or ATP synthase. Okay, right. So two protons will move across. So continue. The two protons will move across. Continue the statement. The two protons move across the coupling factor. As I already told in the diagram, they move across the coupling factor, and then that is sufficient to add one proton to ATP, which is sufficient to add one ADP and inorganic phosphate to form ATP. So ATP is generated by the two protons. Whereas in non-cyclic photophosphorylation, four protons gives two ATP. Four protons generate in non-cyclic. If you see, the four protons will generate two ATPs. So that is in the non-cyclic. Whereas in cyclic, if you take, it is only one ATP. In cyclic it is one ATP, whereas in non-cyclic it is two ATPs are generated. So this is about the chemiosmotic hypothesis, how the energy is synthesized during the photosynthesis. Okay, so hope it is clear. So with this we have completed the light reaction. So in light reaction, what we have completed? Cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. In cyclic photophosphorylation, what we have discussed is with one ATP energy. If it is non-cyclic, two ATPs and one NADP. So both are formed towards the stroma side. The two ATPs are formed towards the stroma side, and the NADP is also there towards the stroma side. So the energy which is present in the stroma is used during the dark reaction for the fixation of carbon dioxide. So for the carbon dioxide fixation, the energy is used. That energy should be present in the stroma. Why? Because dark reaction occurs in the stroma. So dark reaction occurs in the stroma, the energy is also present in the stroma. Therefore we see dark reaction, that is Kelvin cycle and followed by C4 cycle. So C3 cycle and C4 cycle takes place in the stroma. So that is Kelvin cycle and followed by Hatch-Slack pathway. Okay, right. So next we have to discuss about the dark reaction. So dark reaction, keep the heading dark reaction. So in the dark reaction, the two major pathways are C3 cycle and C4 cycle. Okay. So dark reaction, we already discussed about the dark reaction, the major points. So it takes place during the daytime. Dark reaction occurs during the daytime, but it is independent to the light. That means it don't use the light. So it does not use the light. Why? Because it already uses in the light reaction, the light is already used. But whereas in the dark reaction, always depends on the light reaction. Dark reaction always depends on the light reaction. On what basis they are depending? On the energy which is synthesized in the light reaction. So that light reaction, so that is why dark reaction uses the energy. It is depending on the light reaction. Depending on the light reaction, but it occurs during the daytime. It does not mean that it occurs in the night time. It occurs in the daytime, but it is independent of the light. It is independent of the light. It does not use the light. So dark reaction, note down, dark reaction. So dark reaction occurs during the daytime, but it is independent. But it is independent to the light. But it is independent to the light. That means it is independent to the light, but it is depending on the product of the light reaction. It depends on the product, that is nothing but the assimilatory power. What is assimilatory power? The ATP and NADPH2. This is an assimilatory power. So it depends on the dark reaction, depends on the products of light reaction. Products of the light reaction. So that is what we see in the dark reaction. So this dark reaction takes place. So it occurs in the dark reaction occurs in the stroma, because where energy is present, in that it occurs. So dark reaction takes place in the stroma. So dark reaction pathways are, so it fixes the, during dark reaction, the carbon dioxide is fixed. So fixation of CO2 fixation, the carbon dioxide is fixed by the energy to form food, to generate the food. The food is nothing but the carbohydrates. So that reaction, the CO2 is fixed by the energy to form the carbohydrates, to produce the carbohydrates. So that is what we see in the DARC reaction. So two major pathways. The pathways in the DARC reaction are C3 cycle and C4 cycle. C3 cycle is Kelvin cycle and C4 cycle is Hatch-Lack pathway. C4 cycle is called as Hatch-Lack pathway. So let us see these pathways so that you will understand how does the DARC reaction synthesizes the food. So definitely they should prepare the food material, that is carbohydrate. So still we have not completed the preparation of the food, because during photosynthesis finally carbohydrates should be produced. So that glucose to produce, it will produce in the form of C3 cycle and C4 cycle. So till now only half of the photosynthesis takes place, which is by the light reaction. So, but in the DARC reaction, if you see, the food has to be synthesized. So that will be synthesized by the Kelvin cycle and Hatch-Lack pathway. So keep the heading C3 cycle. C3 cycle or Kelvin cycle. So this cycle is very important. So how does it take place? So C3 cycle is also called Kelvin cycle, C3 cycle the C3 cycle is also called as a Kelvin cycle or PCR cycle. So what is this PCR cycle? PCR cycle is nothing but the photosynthetic carbon reduction cycle. C3 cycle, Kelvin cycle or PCR cycle or RPP cycle. There are different names which are given to the C3 cycle. The RPP means reductive pentose phosphate, photosynthetic carbon reduction full form. PCR, photosynthetic carbon reduction, and RPP is the reductive pentose phosphate pathway, reductive pentose phosphate. So that is called as RPP. So this C3 cycle was proposed by Melvin Kelvin. The cycle was proposed by Melvin Kelvin. It was proposed by scientist Melvin Kelvin, who got the Nobel Prize in 1961. who got the Nobel Prize in 1961. So therefore the pathway is of more importance. Not only the Melvin Kelvin, along with him, the main scientist is Kelvin, so the name is called as Kelvin cycle. Along with him, Andrew Benson and James Bassam also. So these two scientists, Andrew Benson and James Bassam, they also are involved in the C3 cycle, who got the Nobel Prize along with Kelvin. Okay? Right. So they are also involved in the C3 cycle. They worked. The major is by Kelvin. And along with that, Andrew Benson and James Bassam also involved. So where does they worked? On what? On where they have first performed, they have studied this Kelvin cycle is the photosynthetic algae Chlorella. So photosynthetic, they studied on the photosynthetic algae Chlorella. They studied on the photosynthetic algae, which is Chlorella, which is radio labeled. It supplied the radioactive carbon 14. So they provided radioactive carbon 14. In that way, carbon dioxide they have provided, because carbon dioxide should be fixed. The carbon is given with C14, so radioactive carbon. And with this, on this, they have performed the experiment. Okay. Next, so here they identified that the first product was the formed, which is nothing but 3-PGA. The first product which is formed, is 3-PGA. That means phosphoglyceric acid. So 3-PGA, phosphoglyceric acid. So that phosphoglyceric acid is the first product, which is a 3-carbon compound, which is a 3-carbon compound. As it is a 3-carbon compound, therefore the cycle is called as a C3 cycle. Because of the first product. The name of the cycle came from the first product which is formed, that is nothing but the C3 cycle. So this is, and the plants which are involved are C3 plants, and the plants are called C3 plants. So those plants in which the Kelvin cycle takes place, those plants are all called as C3 plants, which produces the C3-PGA, phosphoglyceric acid. So such kind of product which is produced. So therefore the cycle is called as a C3 cycle. So three important steps are involved in this. the three major steps. Let us see the pathway, how it undergoes. So how does this formation of glucose or carbohydrate takes place? So the three important steps which occurs in the C3 cycle, the three steps which occurs in the C3 cycle, which is carboxylation. The first step is called carboxylation. Next, the second step is called reduction. Carboxylation. So three steps. Carboxylation, reduction, and regeneration. Carboxylation, reduction, and regeneration are the three steps which takes place in the C3 cycle. So what are these three steps? So let us see the pathway. So if you see the pathway, then you will clearly understand. So the first step is, we in the carboxylation we see the formation of what? The formation of the RU, that is 12, that is PGA. So which PGA? That is phospho-3-PGA, phosphoglyceric acid. So note down the cycle. Carboxylation. So what happens in the carboxylation is carbon dioxide, which is associated with the RUBP, ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate. So let us see the cycle. So then you'll clearly understand. So the cycle involves, the RUBP is the product, what is the substrate which accepts the carbon dioxide. RUBP the carbon dioxide and water, which will be added to the RUBP. So this RUBP, six molecules, how many molecules? Very important, six molecules of RUBP, six molecules of carbon dioxide, and six molecules of water. So to form one glucose, always there should be six molecules of carbon dioxide. That is why we tell 6CO2, like that. So this forms in the presence of an enzyme called Rubisco. An enzyme which is involved in the first carboxylation, very very important bit. So this is Rubisco. Ribulose, full form of Rubisco is ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate carboxylase oxygenase. So that is called as Rubisco. So Rubisco is an abundant protein in the plant kingdom. So this Rubisco, which is an enzyme or a protein which is involved in the first step of carboxylation, where you see RUBP reacts with carbon dioxide, six molecules, to form 12 molecules of 3-PGA. 12 molecules of 3-PGA, phosphoglyceric acid. Phosphoglyceric acid. 3-PGA. How many molecules? 12 molecules. How 12 molecules? Let us see. 3-PGA, phosphoglyceric acid, is how many carbons? 3 carbon compound. So if it is 3 carbon compound, let us see. RUBP is how many carbon compound? 5 carbon. RUBP, ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate, full form of RUBP is ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate. Ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate. So ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate is a 5-carbon compound. How many molecules? 6. So 6 × 5 = 30. The number of carbons are 30. And carbon dioxide is how many carbons? 1 carbon. Total number of carbon dioxide are 6 carbons. So 6 × 30 = 36. So 36 carbons are involved. 36 carbon dioxide, 36 carbons are formed in the first product. So if 1 PGA is 3 carbon, total 36 to get, how many PGA molecules will be there? 12 PGA molecules. So therefore 12 × 3 = 36. So 12 molecules of 3 PGA, if they form only, they can compensate the number of carbons which are involved in the carboxylation reaction. So this step is called as carboxylation. First step, carboxylation. The first step of carboxylation forms the, will form the RUB, that will form the PGA, 3 PGA. So that means with the 3 PGA, whatever it is forming, that will develop. So here, the 3 PGA molecule which is formed will undergo reduction. So the second step is called reduction. The second step is called as reduction. So in the reduction, if you see, whatever is the product which is forming, so that product which is forming is